close to robbing your projects. Pain driven, itching, drumming. Look how far we coming. Heartbeat on the streets, you can do it. Pain real for the weekend. Sweet, this sugar. One man army, but get deep. Watch what you doing. I ain't damaged goods, damming out the clay. Do what you could. I do this for the family. I might just blow my wheel. I'm keeping it so for real. Who feeling that glowing hill? I'm giving they souls the chills. My journey cold is chill. Stories treacherous, I effortlessly show them skills. Yeah.
Coach, while much of the country is struggling under cold temps and some of that white stuff, no such troubles here. Coach, while much of the country is struggling under cold temps and some of that white stuff, no such troubles here at Hard Rock Stadium in Miami. The excitement brewing here in South Florida as a moment ago the Dolphins starters were introduced to this home crowd. They're fired up as well as they get set to match up with Carson Wentz and the Philadelphia Eagles. The calendar has turned to December, and we're in the home stretch now as we're underway in week 13. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Tight end Mike Gesicki. 5 yards on the game's first play. Second down. The catches like that, that's what the Dolphins envisioned when they took Gesicki high in the second round a season ago. He did have 22 catches as a rookie, but did not find the end zone. Certainly feels more comfortable wearing number 88, his old college number, after sporting 86 as a rookie. Ball on the 30. They'll come up with a second and five. Now a man who really stepped up last year. This is Matt Breida. And now off to the races, down the right side. And all the way in for a Miami touchdown. Matt Breida with touchdown number 8 on the year. As his guys are able to strike first here in this opening quarter. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And it's now a 7-0 game. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll take it up past the 25 to the 26-yard line. Wentz and the Eagles now with a first and 10 at their own 26. Throwing is Wentz. Now they go screen. It's complete. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. Now, Charles, what's the mindset here offensively? You gave up a touchdown pretty quickly. Would it have changed if you had gotten a stop and it would be 0-0 right now, or no?
I wouldn't think so. I think in most cases, just down a touchdown, you know, I mean, we're just getting started here. It should be a long way to go. You think to yourself, stick with the game plan, all the things you worked on in practice. But you have some teams that when they get down, their natural tendency is to aggressively strike back. And let's see if they want to get outside of the game plan we expect and try and be aggressive on their first series.
That last catch short of the marker by just a yard leaves him with a very manageable second and one. Now a first-time Pro Bowler from a year ago, Lamar Miller. And he'll get it out near the 40 to the 39. They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I know what you're thinking out there. I know a lot of you are thinking, take a shot downfield. It's a great spot for it. I'd say maybe later in the game, definitely in the second half. But right now, I think they were just trying to get some momentum built. Get a first down, pick it up, and keep moving.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. He'll look to throw. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Yeah, that one sailed on him. You've got to make sure you give your receiver a chance to come down inbounds because they are very gifted. They'll make the circus catches, but if they make them out of bounds, that does you no good.
So line of scrimmage, still the 39 on second and 10.
Check three. Under crush. He's coming. Double up, double up. He's coming. Double up.
We're done.
To throw is Wentz. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Big Shaq Lawson gets the sack there. And we say it all the time, have to be able to get rid of the ball sooner than that.
You have to help your offensive line out. They're going to protect you as best they can. And if you're getting 3 to 5 seconds to throw the ball, they're doing a really nice job. But when you hold it and give up a sack, you're really almost discrediting their work.
Eagles coming up here on a third and long, so Wentz and company with some work to do after the sack.
Mike, 55, check 55, Mike.
Working from the gun, Wentz. And he connects with Ertz. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. A pickup of 27, and they pick up the first down in the process. A first down carry now for Miller. And he's corralled at the 40, but not before picking up 8. Now the Dolphins are going to halt the action here. It's a timeout. They'll have 2 remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. Go. 8 yards the tally on that first down run. Here's 2nd and 2. They'll try the right side here with Miller. And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
2nd and 2 is prime time for a little bit of a gamble, isn't it? Open up the playbook, go play action, toss that bad boy deep. But in this situation, go ahead and give it to your back. Let him pick up a first down, keep the sticks moving.
So from the 36 now, 1st and 10. Wentz now to throw. It's caught by Sanders. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on 1st down.
I'm not sure that this play was designed for him specifically, but they got through the progressions and got the ball to him. So 2nd catch on the drive. He may not be a primary guy, but they definitely want him involved, don't they?
Absolutely. This early, the opening drive, as you said, 2 catches. So if they can get him going in the passing game, that should open up his running game, too. This is the former Nittany Lion, the rookie Miles Sanders. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15. Quite the opening drive march they're on right now.
It looks a lot like what we saw in practice prior to the game, doesn't it? You know, because on that last big practice beforehand, you go through your offensive script. You go through your play calling. You go through all the stuff and establish things. And it looks like it's going like clockwork right now for them.
Right back to Sanders on 1st down. And strong running there as he's inside the 10 and down to the 8-yard line. 5 yards is the tally on 1st down. That brings up 2nd and 5.
Brings up 2nd and 5 at the 8-yard line.
After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5.
Hey, empty.
It's a 2nd down run with Sanders. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Miles Sanders, his 6th touchdown of the season, as his guys are on the board here in this first quarter. On for the extra point, Jake Elliott. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece.
Thank you.
Each team's had it. Each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And they had to wait a long time to get the football back. Probably not what you were hoping for when you got an offensive helmet.
Agreed. What you were looking for is the defense getting the ball back pretty quickly, right? Hoping for a three and out. So that didn't happen. You can't yell at your D for that. They've got to take care of their own business and reestablish themselves now that they're back on the field.
3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
Well, it's time for them to be good teammates right here. What I mean by that is possess the ball for a little while. Get at least 2 first downs. Give their defense a chance to settle down a little bit after they give up a touchdown.
Here's 2nd and 7 now from the 28. Here's a 2nd and 7. Escaping the pressure right. And eventually taken down here. Great coverage downfield. You never want to give up a sack. From the O-line's perspective, they hate it for several reasons, especially because they felt like they let little brother down back there in the pocket.
Oh, no doubt. They have a ton of pride, and they go into every job wanting to keep that guy clean. They want that uniform with no grass stains, no dirt, nothing on it. But it's really, really difficult. You're talking about some terrific athletes who are trying to put him on the ground.
Hey, get it. He's crashing. He's checking crash. Check, check. Lucky, lucky, lucky.
Kill, kill, kill.
Deuce, 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 deuce. Switch, switch, switch. Switch, trap, switch.
They'll set up a throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And he will return this one to the 30-yard line. Defensively that time, they were in zone coverage. As a rookie QB, what lesson can you learn there?
Well, understand this. You saw zone in college, and the defensive backs reacted, but they don't react like they do on this level. So when they're in zone and they see the ball coming to them, they'll react at least a half a second faster. You've got to know where you want to go with the ball and be decisive with it. Otherwise, the end result can be something you don't like.
So after the INT, here's Wentz. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And he stopped right at the 25 after a gain of 5.
One thing you're hoping for when you run drag routes, you're able to hit a receiver in stride and he can pick up a lot of yardage after the catch. But in this situation, the defense was effective, able to stop him before he could get a good head of steam going.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Well, they'll run it here on the jet sweep. And he'll be taken down as that will take us to the end of the first quarter of play. These two teams all tied after one. Wentz looking to throw on 3rd and 2. Yeah, he's got it. And he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Marquise Goodwin, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Eagles have taken the lead. Elliott on for the extra point. And he's got it. It's now a 14-7 ball game. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll wind up about 4 yards shy of where he would have been if he had taken a knee, as they'll start at the 21-yard line. First down Miami as they get set to start the drive. That 7-0 lead of theirs short-lived as they've now given up 2 straight touchdowns to fall behind by 7.
Yeah, but no cause for discouragement here. Yeah, they've fallen behind, but haven't they proven that they can go down and score? So what was the formula that got them down there the first time? Get back to something close to that, and maybe they can get this game tied up.
Here's Breida. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. That one, a first down pickup of 8.
For a lot of guys playing this game, there's no better feeling than running right through a tackle. He's able to lower center of gravity and churn his legs for a really nice pickup.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. He'll drop to throw. Rolling to his right. He's going to take off. Now a loose football. The ball comes out, and it's picked up by the Eagles.
When I see a play like that, I come back to risk-reward. I don't know about you, but is it worth it at that point, whatever you're going to pick up, to either take the hit, and in this case, lose the football.
So should have gone down. I mean, hindsight's always 20-20, but that's the safe play.
You're exactly right. Hindsight's really never wrong, is it? Because you can analyze it. But I think ultimately you got to look at it as a first option, taking care of the ball, getting what you can, and that's it. Don't worry about it anymore.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders with his second touchdown of the game, number 7 on the year. And the Eagles able to push further out in front. Elliott good on the extra point, and it's now 21-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This will be taken in at the 1. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
You always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you.
Second and 5 after the 5-yard completion on first down. Second and 5. And oh, look at that, a diving catch. That one good for 26 and a first down.
There's simply no sense in wasting a great catch like that on a short gain. Get downfield like you just did there and use it up that way.
No dink and dunk. So from Philadelphia territory now, here's a first and 10 at the 46. They run with Breida. And that'll hurt the average a bit as this time they're able to get him behind the line. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Every year I go to the combine and marvel at the speeds that linebackers are running nowadays. They run like DBs. And let's face it, they know how to finish plays too. Eyes up, head up, run right through them.
Second and 11. Going to be hit and taken down. Back right around a 48-yard line. Derek Barnett in there to get him, and that is sack number 6 now for him on the year. So two plays with only negative yardage to show, and now it's third and 16. They'll drop the throw. Airing this one out for Evans. And that'll be incomplete. Well, they took their shot all right, but it comes up empty, and it's fourth down.
But one thing's for sure, when you've got a big receiver and you trust him downfield, you're going to give him opportunities to go up and get that 50-50 ball.
And he is a darn good big receiver. Unfortunately, that time didn't work out. Nice job defensively. And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Offense set to begin their next drive. And the ledger for them so far looks pretty good, doesn't it?
It certainly does. Touchdown, touchdown, touchdown. Not sure it can be much better than that. They've got to feel very good about the groove that they're in at this stage of the game.
I got this, you man. Me. I got this.
They start on the ground here at Sanders. And they're able to get this one across the 35. It's a gain of 16 and an Eagle first down.
Now, this is an example of breaking down a defense, because on a lot of these runs, he's getting past the point of attack, and guess what he's doing? Forcing the secondary guys to have to make a lot of tackles.
So from the 36 now, first and 10.
Watch the slip. By 52.
Check four.
Hey, look.
He's playing.
Here's Wentz to throw. This short throw caught by Goddard. 7 yards, the pickup on the pitch and catch.
It certainly feels like there are more stars at the tight end position than there were even 10 years ago. And I think it's become more of a glamour position because of the ways it can hurt a defense, and guys want to be involved. They can be in line, close to the line of scrimmage. They can split out like receivers. But hands, route running, speed, and some toughness to go across the middle, you put it all together, you've got a heck of a tight end candidate.
Able to get 7 on that first down pass play. Second and 3.
Watch the ship.
And he'll be taken down, but not before he works it past the 50. 10 yards there and an Eagle first down.
Partner, if you want more carries, I think we saw how you get him. Showed that he's got the fresh legs, and he picked up the first down on that run. Don't just ask for them. Show them that you're supposed to get the football.
So now first and 10 as they've crossed into Miami territory at the 47. And they'll run it from the gun with Miller. And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35. It's an Eagles first down on a gain of 11.
We both know it's difficult, but they've made it look effortless out there. Through the air, on the ground, they've moved the ball with relative ease.
Two minutes remaining in this first half of football.
Let's go, let's do this.
A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll send you up to Orlando. Jonathan Coachman is there, and he'll have stats and scores from a busy Sunday in the NFL.
Check 26, check 26. Ram.
Throwing on first is Wentz. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. It's a gain of 13 and a first down for Philadelphia. Wentz going to lead his guys up first and 10. And he's completed all seven of his passes thus far. And able to work his way down to the 16. 7 yards on the pickup there, and it'll leave him with a second and 3. A lot to praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3.
Say, low. Out. Check. Fresno.
Watch safety creeping. Safety's creeping.
Under 10.
Wentz gonna throw. Going right side here, and that's complete. The Eagles going to take the first of their timeouts. as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. First and 10, it's Sanders. And he'll get this one down to about the 10-yard line. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and 9.
Absolutely love the effort there. The ability to flow from his inside spot and stop that one at the line of scrimmage. Nice linebacker play.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9. Now Wentz. Flushed out right. And that's going to be incomplete. 12 seconds left. The Pro Bowl tight end Zach Ertz, the intended target. And that takes us from second to third down. Play number 9 on the drive coming up, and they need 9 yards on third down. On third down, they turn to Sanders. And he is into the end zone. Touchdown, Philadelphia. Miles Sanders in the final seconds of the first half. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
That's one of the better examples of clock management I've seen. Whittled it all the way down just about and still put the ball in the end zone.
Yeah, just a methodical drive and something really to take into the lockers here. Elliott now to add the extra point. He knocks it through. It's 28-7. Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. Time here for likely one play, then off to the locker room, and they're going to have some adjustments to make.
They certainly will, and I think a lot of people are thinking to themselves, all right, take the knee, get out of here, regroup. But how will the head coach and his staff approach halftime? Will it be angry? Will it be clinical? Will they be calm? Will they just let it all out? Who knows? I'd love to be a fly on the wall for this one, though.
And throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete. So we reach halftime in what's been a fairly one-sided game so far. As we send you up to Orlando to check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. So the Eagles with the lead, and they're going to get this football first as the third quarter gets underway. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to bring it out, a good one, as he's up a yard or two shy of the 30. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively.
You can't block me. You can't block me.
Let's go, Greg.
Wentz now on first down. Blitz coming and down he goes. Give the sack to Jerome Baker.
They need to stop to get back into this game, and here's one right to start the third quarter.
Yeah, anytime you go into the lockers with that 2-3 score deficit, you're right. You need that stop, get the football back, and they've done just that.
Series to series, play to play.
And they need to work to at least get some of this yardage back after the sack. Second and 19.
Kill, kill, kill. Kill, kill. Alert flare, alert flare, flare, flare.
Throwing now is Wentz. Going to throw right side here. Complete. 19 yards to pick up there. Move the chains.
Partner, this is one of the best routes anyone can have in their offensive playbook. Tough to defend because you think it's a go route, and then he breaks it back on the comeback. There's one other thing you need as well.
A well-thrown ball.
Exactly right. Got a guy who has some precision in throwing the football because of the timing of the route.
Trying for the tight end. Ertz, and it's intercepted. Picked off near the 32. Past the 20. There he goes, right side. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Those free safeties, they get to sit back there if they've got good pass rushers like this team does. Read like a book. He read it like a book and took it in for six.
And if they use their eyes well and their anticipation skills, they can make big plays just as what we saw. A free safety's dream. Follow the football, go to it, and take it the other way.
So they'll get another shot on offense following that pick six. And now the kick is away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take this one near the 25, call it the 26-yard line. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And following the pick six, and they have decent field position in throwing that pick six, we'll see how they attack this drive.
And I think all you say to your guy is, listen, just take care of the football a little bit better. Make some better decisions on this drive, and they'll probably help him a little bit with maybe some really high percentage throws early to let him get settled back in.
But they told us, they've got confidence. That's not a problem.
Yeah, not a problem at all. They just want to make sure they get things settled down a little bit for their offense and give their defense a little bit of a chance to rest.
A loss of a yard there to start out. That leads to a second and 11.
Sunday. Shit.
From the gun, it's Wentz. Caught by the tight end, Ertz. Philadelphia picking up the first on a gain of 15.
Almost not fair. The big guy running the corner route, being able to lean and push and get to where he wants.
So how do you stop it?
A lot of times you want to have a linebacker on him, a bigger body guy who can handle him physically. But a lot of times that doesn't work as well because his quickness often wins the route.
It's our time. It's our time.
On first down, Wentz. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Kyle Van Noy, make that now 8 sacks for him on the season. Great job defensively. I think he was trying to go through his progressions, find someone to get rid of the football. Before he knew it, he was on his back.
So that just brings us right back to what you said in the beginning. A great job defensively. Nowhere to go with the football. That led to the sack.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go. Wentz. A pickup of about 3 yards as he's taken down at the 31.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir, able to turn that into a positive gain.
Waiting!
52! Watch the flat! Watch the flat! Watch the flat! Watch the flat! Show it up! Show it up!
Hey! Empty! Empty! No, 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 no!
On third and long, it's Wentz. Goodwin able to haul it in. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. 21 yards there on third down.
First down, Philadelphia.
He's such a good route runner. Shows it there on third down. Very proficient and a good pass.
And you know what I've observed over the years in the NFL? The better a route runner you are, the more confidence your guy's going to have in you to go to you in important times, because he can trust you being in the right spot. And they connected there and picked up a first down.
The previous run, good for 9. Here's second and a yard.
Set the tone, defense. Set the tone, defense. Let's go. Check 31. Check 31.
Now Wentz. Under a heavy rush, and down he goes. Jerome Baker able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
The amount of sacks that they've absorbed in this game is absolutely extraordinary. Let's just face it. This offensive line, flat out, cannot handle this pass rush. It's been demonstrated time and time again.
Now play number 7 of this drive, but it's a tough 3rd and 9. To throw, it's Wentz. And the throw there going to be incomplete.
Even without a ton of pressure in his face, it just shows how difficult it is to pick apart his own defense. Those guys are sitting back, and they're not playing receivers as much as they're playing the eyes of the quarterback and when he delivers the ball.
Here's Jake Elliott. Career long, by the way, for him, 61 yards. This to equal Matt Prater's record. It's a 64-yard attempt. And this is good. It was running out of gas there at the end, but he winds up getting just enough on it. So there you go, partner. How about that?
Oh, that was pretty cool.
That will tie the all-time record set by Matt Prater of the Broncos back in 2013.
And you know, when Prater hit from 64, that was like breaking DiMaggio's streak or breaking the 4-minute mile of Bannister. Tom Dempsey, 63, that was a legendary number. So to top that here, even if it just ties the record, pretty darn awesome.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And here we are, almost through 3 quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
Here's a 2nd and 2 now from the 33.
56. Come to my world. We want it. Come to my world.
Watch out, watch out, watch out, watch out.
They run again with Breida. And he'll be brought down shy of the 40 at the 38-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
You know what really fires up offensive linemen? When the guy that is carrying the ball behind them can create his own space and break a tackle along the way.
So here's a 1st and 10 at the 38. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. All that, and it only nets him a yard. It's 2nd down.
Nice hit, boy.
The goal of a wide receiver screen is get enough blockers in front to create a wall and let him pick his spot to run the football. How about the defense there, swarming to it and not allowing that to happen? Did not let him get downfield.
Pick me up. Here we go.
On second down, a run with Breida. That's going to go down as a loss of five, and it brings up third down. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with this third down play as we play three quarters. This is the National Football League on EA Sports. Throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Fletcher Cox in there to get him, and that is now sack number 18 on the season for it. Slim hopes are going to ride on this one. They'll go on fourth down.
He's coming, he's coming, he's coming. We got double up.
Yeah, yeah.
Watch twist.
As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. He's going to float this one deep right side. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. The Dolphins can't convert on fourth down. And the Eagles are going to take over in great field position. They'll run on first down. Miller, about 3 yards there to the 27.
Well, that's a pretty good drive starter right there. And I don't know, partner, if you're even thinking about sitting on the ball right now. They may just want to run their regular offense.
In plus territory. And as an offensive coordinator, you don't want your team to go into a shell, do you?
No, you really don't. Because as soon as you take your foot off the gas, it's real hard to put it back on and mash it, because once everyone's emotions come down, hard to start them up again. So I think you may want to keep them cranking high right here.
They'll run it again with Miller. Lamar Miller, and he'll take it into the end zone for an Eagles touchdown. Lamar Miller, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Eagles able to push further out in front.
Well, partner, that was another explosive run. And one thing I've learned in our time in this game, yes, the offensive line has to get a lot of credit, but for big runs to occur, the wide receivers have to block well downfield.
And then you have to have a good guy carrying the ball too, right?
Oh, without a doubt. You need that difference maker lugging the rock.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And he'll take it back to about the 19-yard line. First down, Miami, as they get set to start the drive. And last time out, went for it on fourth down, turned it over, gave them great field position, turned into 6 points, so they've got to recover here, Charles.
It's amazing what one decision can do in the chain of events, right? The decision to go for it on fourth down
caused all of that.
It caused every bit of it, but it showed confidence. Hey, I've got confidence in you guys. Go pick it up for them. Didn't happen. Also showed confidence in the defense. They didn't pick up their end of the bargain. So now they've got to come back out and start over and rebuild that confidence.
And down he goes, but he takes it up to the 40. 18 big yards on that one. And a Miami first.
I like watching the wide receiver screens. It's a real teamwork play because guess what? The guy catching the ball, he'll get all the credit, but how about the people up to block in front of him, either fellow receivers or offensive linemen? That makes that play a really nice timing play, and sometimes it can break big.
On first down, here's Breida. They give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and 6.
I call that play a success. A nice inside run sets up a very manageable second down. A very solid gain on that play.
Second and 6. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Fletcher Cox in there for the sack, and he's closing in on the all-time record. That's number 19 on the year. The Dolphins on third down, 0 for 3 to this point. They could use a conversion. This will be third and 15. On third down, a run from Breida. And a nice move will yield nothing as he's stopped behind the line. That'll make it fourth down after a loss of 1.
Oh, partner, that play brought back memories. Watching them string it out, letting the runner get all the way to the sideline area, but not letting him get out of bounds. They formed that picket fence and didn't allow him through.
Not only that, got him for a loss as well here. And one of the reasons they lead in the fourth quarter, plays like that.
Yeah, it took a little more time off the clock, making him do it that way, didn't it?
Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback. The Eagles offense set to begin their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
That goes for a gain of 31. Boy, another big play late here for an offense, Charles. It certainly has had its fair share of big plays.
Coverage has been a problem all game long. And I would say that going along with that has been confidence. Because even if they had the right coverage, they've still dented them. And now it's been a real issue for them during this game.
So the line of scrimmage moves all the way across the 50 now as they come up first and 10. To throw is Wentz. And that'll wind up incomplete. Trying to give his man room to run under it, but it's second down. Fourth quarter, you've got the big lead. If you're coaching, Charles, you still taking shots like that downfield?
I'd be a little more concerned with running some clock and making sure you're taking care of the lead because you keep flinging it around, you throw a couple of picks, you could put yourself in jeopardy.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. On the counter, it's Miller. Only a yard on the pickup there, so it leaves them needing a conversion here on third and a tough 9.
Bottom line, they want to keep this clock rolling, so they'll take that one right there. They just want to keep falling forward, and they want to put the onus on the big fellas up front in order to bring this one home.
The Eagles on third down. They've been near perfect, 4 for 5 to this point. This is third and 9. They're going to look to throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. Shaq Lawson picks up his second sack of the afternoon.
Sometimes I watch games and wonder why they use play fakes on certain passing situations because it's not going to fool anyone. I don't know if that was the case here, but the end result was the same. No one fooled. The quarterback was hit.
And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. And we are inside of 2 minutes left in this lopsided affair. So the Dolphins have it as we welcome you back in. They've got a first and 10 as they search for a late score. They'll start on the ground with Breida. And a short gain here across the 10 to the 12.
That's it, baby.
Defensively, it was Avante Maddox with a tackle.
They tried a quick hitter inside, but that one was swallowed up because what they're hoping, this big defensive lineman will take the bait and move laterally and open up a crease that they can run through. Didn't happen on that play.
Now back to throw. Pressure gets to him and down he goes. Back at the 4-yard line. Duke Riley able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon.
Remember throughout my career here, in defensive coaches always say, guys, you got to earn the right to rush the passer. Well, they put themselves in a great spot with this big lead, and they know they've got to throw the ball.
These pass rushers have to be salivating. It is pin your ears back time indeed.
They'd like to avoid punting from their own end zone so they could use something here on third down. Off the play fake, he'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. Into a double team and it's intercepted. Picked off by Avante Maddox. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Third and long that time. He was trying to make something happen, but a little too risky.
Well, the field tilted on him. And what I mean by that is what you said. Third and long. Got to push it downfield to try and pick up the first down. Defensive backs live for this situation. And they took advantage of the young man right there.
So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Like he'll throw here. He's going to sling this deep downfield. That's caught inside the 20. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, with that touchdown pass, I'm going to bring up a point from earlier in the year. Some of the fans were saying, when do we turn to the rookie? Well, he's looking pretty good right now.
Yeah, I love the fact that the fans are bringing that up because I'm not the head coach, okay? So he's got to deal with it. But I think it's a legitimate question. With the way their season is going, I think now is the time to turn the page and let him get some starts before this season is over.
Now after the touchdown, here's Elliott on to kick it away. Fielded about a yard deep. And the decision to come out is going to cost him five as he's taken down right at the 20. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive.
They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest.
Don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
exactly.
Going forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today, coaching, playing, the whole deal, and never forget it because
you're not going to want that feeling again.
No, you don't want that feeling again, and who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
3 yards is half of what they needed. Now can they get the other three here on third down?
That's a gain of three. Brings up third and three.
Of explosion help leading them to victory, and the defensive guys, they're just saying, hey, put those points up every week, we'll just keep winning.
They will gratefully accept them, won't they? It makes their job that much easier when they're scoring that many points, allows them to play with a totally different style and a different flow.
So for the Eagles, the win moves them a couple games over 500 now at 7-5. And they will head back home next week. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, the playoffs look to be out of reach now as they drop to 4-8. And they'll try and turn things around next week as they have a date at MetLife Stadium with the New York Jets. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gauden saying so long, everybody.